This is Apollo Control. Columbia now 82,972 nautical miles out from Earth. Traveling inbound at 6,546 feet per second. There have been no further communications with the crew of Apollo 11 in the last half hour or so. At this time, they should be going through their pre-sleep checklist or possibly their evening meal before beginning a 7-hour rest period. We'll take down the circuit at this time and come back when and if the conversation resumes prior to the time the crew begins their rest period. At 180 hours, 3 minutes, ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control.
This is Delta Launch Control. We're now T-minus 13 minutes, 53 seconds, and counting. We're now receiving some preliminary status checks. We have a report from spacecraft that spacecraft status is ready. Also a report from the Superintendent of Range Operations that the range is ready to support. As we look at the range status board here in the Mission Director's Center, all stations are showing green. Liquid oxygen topping has now reached liquid oxygen loading has now reached 100% and will continue to top down to the final seconds before launch. The liquid oxygen is stored and transferred at minus 297 degrees Fahrenheit, so there is some boil off which does occur. This boil off is vented to the outside air, and these vents will be closed just prior to launch. The tanks will be pressurized, thus ensuring a full LOX load. Right now, we're also monitoring the helium and nitrogen pressure in the systems on the second stage. These systems used to pressurize the fuel systems on the second stage. Helium is maintained at approximately 4,350 PSIG, and the nitrogen at 4,000 PSIG. We'll continue to monitor these. We have one more built-in hold at the countdown, this coming at the T-minus 5-minute mark, and it will be for 5 minutes duration. Now at T-minus 12 minutes, 30 seconds and counting, this is Delta Launch Control. This is Delta Launch Control. We're at T-minus 7 minutes, 50 seconds, and continuing to count in our countdown for the Intelsat 3. However, it has been noted that a nitrogen regulator on the second stage is malfunctioning. This nitrogen regulator controls the nitrogen going into the attitude control system. If the problem cannot be solved, this is a no-go item. We'll continue to work the problem and to look at it. As we proceed with the count, the countdown will continue to the T-minus 5-minute mark, at which time a built-in hold is scheduled. During that built-in hold, the overall situation will be evaluated, and we'll bring you the word on that just as soon as we receive it here in the Mission Director's Center. Now at T-minus 7 minutes, 10 seconds and counting, this is Delta Launch Control. This is Delta Launch Control. We're now T-minus 5 minutes and holding. This is our planned built-in hold. We'll take advantage of this hold time to make a further examination of that nitrogen regulator aboard the second stage of the Delta launch vehicle. This nitrogen regulator is malfunctioning at this time. It's used to regulate the nitrogen which flows to the attitude control system in the second stage. We'll be standing by here in the Mission Director's Center for a go-no-go on that system. If the nitrogen regulator continues to malfunction, it will be a no-go item. We'll stand by here during the built-in hold, and we'll bring you word as soon as we receive it in the Mission Director's Center. T-minus 5 minutes in holding. This is Delta Launch Control. This is Delta Launch Control. We're T-minus 5 minutes and holding. We've just received word from Launch Director Robert Gray that the launch has been scrubbed for tonight. The reason for the scrub being the nitrogen regulator aboard the second stage, which is malfunctioning at this time. This nitrogen regulator regulates the nitrogen going into the attitude control system on the second stage. We will attempt to recycle for countdown tomorrow. Checks must be made with the range to ensure that we can get a range clearance for tomorrow night launch. If we do, the launch window will be the same tomorrow night, 10 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time to 11:10 p.m. This is Delta Launch Control.
This is Apollo Control, 180 hours, 25 minutes, ground elapsed time. We have some 4 minutes accumulated tape in recent transmissions between Columbia and the ground. We'll roll these tapes at this time.
Houston, you might tell Buzz not to exercise quite so strenuously. Over.
That's Brown.
Say again.
That's Brown.
Okay, that's one on us. 11 Houston, seriously, that comment was just aimed at your musical selection.
Okay.
Exercise?
Just running the ergometer.
Roger. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over. We'd like to know what your plans are as far as turning in this evening. The flight plan we show you commencing a rest period of about 182 hours. You know, what are you planning to do on that? We're going to be watching the weather here, and we expect to have an update on the weather, I guess, in about another half hour or 45 minutes to pass to you. Over.
We're going to probably stick with the flight plan pretty much. We are going to check the lights in the northwest corner of the U.S. and southwest corner of Canada. If we can see up that high into the northern hemisphere, other than that, we'll be on the flight plan.
Roger. For your information, the laser from McDonald Observatory in West Texas will be up from about 181 hours and 30 minutes on for 1 hour. You should be able to spot the Earth out of the number one window every time you pass roll 357 degrees, and they, of course, are in West Texas. Over.
Okay, thank you. How about the number five window?
Stand by a minute. Roger, for the number five window, that'll be every time you pass 230 degrees and roll. Over.
Beautiful. Thank you. You guys are on your toes down there.
Roger.
Must have a new star chart. Must have a new star chart, huh?
Oh, we've got a fresh FAO here.
Honeysuckle, Houston, come check. Net one, voice check.
Honeysuckle, read you loud and clear.
Roger, read you the same.
Apollo 11, how much longer do you want to keep charging battery B?
11, this is Houston. And nominally, we're looking for about another hour and a half, but what we'd like to do is continue charging until shortly before you turn in for the night. Over.
That'll be fine. Are you going to want to charge A again at all?
Negative 11.
Okay.
11, this is Houston. At about 180.45, we'll be handing over from Goldstone to Honeysuckle, and I'm handing over to Charlie. I'll see you when you get back. Over.
Okay, Bruce. Good night. Thank you.
Roger, good night.
Thank you very much, Bruce. Been a pleasure working with you.
Have a nice trip down.
is Apollo Control. The weird noise has been reported by network controller as not being on the downlink from the spacecraft. Now it's stopped. Let's leave the circuit open here in the period prior to the time the crew goes to sleep and monitor the air ground circuit. Thank you. This is Apollo Control. We've been standing by now for quite some time for resumption of communications, but apparently no one is saying anything tonight. Apollo 11 now 78,134 nautical miles out from Earth, approaching at 6,785 feet per second. And at 181 hours, 17 minutes, ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control. Thank you. This is Apollo Control. We've had one brief communication from Apollo 11. Spacecraft communicator Bruce McCandless is out of the room. The assistant flight director, Chuck Lewis, went down to the console to talk. Let's play that tape back and rejoin live when the conversation picks up again.
Houston, Apollo 11, over.
Apollo 11, Houston, go ahead.
Roger, Houston. For retro, I have the anticipated location of all the entry stowage, and I suggest you pull out the entry checklist and we'll go through those maps in the front of it.
Apollo 11, Houston, could you stand by just a few minutes? Charlie and flight are out getting a weather briefing. They'll be back shortly. Say again.
Is this on?
No, this is Chuck Lewis. Charlie Duke is out with flight getting a weather briefing right now.
Okay. They're not drinking coffee, I know.
They'll be back momentarily.
I stand corrected. That's Charlie Duke on the Capcom slot. Bruce McCandless in the last half hour has been relieved. Charlie is likely to respond now. He's putting on his headset. We'll listen in.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston, over.
Roger, Houston, Apollo 11. Did you get the word on the entry checklist?
Roger, Mike. We sure did. We're ready to talk about it if you are, over.
I think the quickest thing is go through page by page the first part of the entry checklist where it has a map. Starting on the page with compartment L2 and L3. Are you with me?
Roger, with you.
Okay, L2 is as shown, L3 is as shown. There's about half the food remaining in L3.
Roger.
Where it says note, the CMP PGA is located in the L-shaped bag with the other two PGAs. The LEM shield was jettisoned with the, or correction, the CMP's helmet shield was jettisoned with the LEM, and his helmet and gloves, instead of being in the sleep restraint, are in the hatchback.
Okay, let's see. Now, your PGA is in the L-shaped bag with the other two PGAs, and your helmet and gloves are in the L-shaped bag instead of the sleep restraint.
The helmet and gloves are in the hatch bag, the great big bag that's underneath the left-hand couch that you put the hatch in.
Roger, I thought that's what I copied. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, the next page is identical. Except nitpicking point at R1, we got the entry checklist. Other than that, it's identical. And the third page has got some changes.
Go ahead.
In A1. Are you with me? I'm over there in compartment A1 now.
Go ahead, Mike. Over.
Okay, compartment A1, the 16mm magazine will be located in window number 4. Instead of 5 tissue dispensers, there's only one of them left. In compartment U3, the 16mm bracket is on window 4. In the PGA bag, add the CMP's PGA plus add 2 LCGs. In compartment A8, delete 2 LCGs, add 1 PPK, making a total of 4, and add 10 pounds of LEM miscellaneous equipment. We told you 5 the other day, we think 10 is probably closer, over.
Copy.
All the changes on that page. Ready for the next page?
Right, go ahead, Mike.
In the next page, in compartment B1, we estimate about 15% of that food is remaining. In B2, we took PPK out of there and put trash in it. In B3, the 16mm cable, the 18mm lens, and the right angle mirror are on window number 4. And that, sir, brings you all up to date.
Roger. How about the levers, Mike? Where'd you put those, over?
They're in the hatchback.
Roger. Stand by. Our only concern, 11, is with the stuff you got in the hatchback. That's a pretty big bulk between you and A8, and we'd like to talk about moving that over to the sleep restraint. If you'll stand by, I'll verify that, over.
Okay.
11 Houston, our recommendation on the gear you got in the helmet bag, correction, the hatchet bag, would be to remove that stuff and put it in the sleep restrainer on the right couch. The reason is that the hatch bag straps are only configured for 0G, and it's a pretty difficult job getting it latched down. With the gear in the sleep restraint, it's a pretty standard latch down procedure, and you can also use the beta cord that you have on board. You concur, over.
Charlie, let you know.
Roger. And I've got a couple other things, Mike. We need to terminate battery B charge at this time. And also, the weather is clobbering in at our targeted landing point due to scattered thunderstorms. We don't want to tangle with one of those, so we're going to move your aim point uprange, correction, to be downrange, to target for a 1,500 nautical mile entry, so we can guarantee lift control. The new coordinates are 13 degrees, 19 minutes north, 169, 10 minutes west. The weather in that area is super. We got 2,000 scattered, 8,000 scattered, with 10 miles visibility, and 6 foot seas, and the Hornet is sitting in great position to get to that targeted position. Over.
Roger.
This is Apollo Control. To recap briefly the conversation a few moments ago between Charlie Duke and the crew of Columbia, because of forecast thunderstorms in the prime recovery area in the mid-Pacific for tomorrow, the Apollo spacecraft's lifting capabilities will be used to stretch the entry path some 215 nautical miles farther downrange toward Hawaii to a new landing point or aiming point with the very rough preliminary coordinates of 13 degrees 19 minutes north by 169 degrees 10 minutes west. These numbers will be refined through the night as the retrofire officer exercises a computer and comes up with more definitive numbers. These will be passed on as they are available. Apollo 11 now 75,951 nautical miles out from Earth, approaching at 6,899 feet per second. At 181 hours 50 minutes and standing by on the air ground circuit, this is Apollo Control.
Apollo 11, Houston, some of the general last-minute updates here. On the entry, we were told you on the camera to set it at 50 feet. Turns out the biggest number on the camera is 25 feet, so just set it at infinity. Over.
Roger, infinity.
21 Houston. We're ready to put you to bed and say good night if you give us your crew status report and verify that you changed out the CO2 canister a moment ago. Over.
Stand by. Charlie, crew status report follows. CDR 11023, CMP 10025, LMP 09027, canister change complete.
Roger, thank you very much.
No medication.
Roger, thank you. Could you give us an onboard readout, please, sir?
Stand by. Okay, Bat C 37, Pyro Bat A 37, Bat B 37, RCSA 51, D 63, C 62, D 58.
Roger, copy. Thank you much. Apollo 11, Houston, it's a good night from the white team for the last time. We'll be off when you wake up in the morning. It's been a pleasure working with you guys. It was a beautiful show from all three of you. We appreciate it very much, and we'll see you when you get out of the LRL, over.
Okay, Charlie, thanks to you and all the white team for a great job down there all the way through. Thank you.
Outstanding.
Thank
you. Appreciate it very much, Charlie. Thanks.
Thanks to you guys, too. In Houston, Mike, you get your chance to landing tomorrow. No go around.
Right, you're gonna let me land closer to Hawaii too, aren't you?
That's right, sir.
This is Apollo Control. All good nights having been said, the crew of Apollo 11 is now preparing to get their 10 hours rest. And their last night in space here in the control center on one of the 10 by 10 IDA4 television projectors. A drawing has been projected on the screen, ribbing Capcom Charlie Duke for his slight error yesterday on the television pass where he mistook the moon for Earth. As a spacecraft midway between moon and Earth, and it says, "Neil, I just spotted a continent on the moon." Charlie, the camera's on the Earth now. Apollo 11 now 74,906 nautical miles out from Earth, approaching at 6,954 feet per second, and at 182 hours 6 minutes ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control. This is Apollo Control, 182 hours, 10 minutes, ground elapsed time. We thought that was all the air to ground for tonight prior to the crew going to sleep, but just a few moments ago there was a brief exchange reporting to Apollo 11 crew that the McDonnell Observatory in far west Texas had the spacecraft in their telescope field of view. Let's roll that tape now and then shut it down again.
11 Houston, we got some word just a moment ago that the McDonnell Observatory is said they had picked up the spacecraft in their telescope. Over.
Outstanding. We've been looking for their laser, but haven't had much luck yet.
Roger, we'll pass it on to them, Neil. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control. That completes the very brief exchange of a few moments ago. At 182 hours, 11 minutes, ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control.
Thank you. Thank you.